Hey everyone, welcome to Extra's Bachelor Breakdown. I'm Hannah Kahn, and she's the spunky, outspoken Southern gal who shook things up on Colton's season of The Bachelor. With me now, Demi!
Hi! I'm so excited to be here.
I'm so happy to have you here.
This is awesome.
How are you, Demi?
I'm doing really well. This has been like the craziest experience of my life, but I am doing so good, and everything that's come from it has just been really amazing.
I'm so happy for you. America loves you.
Oh, thank
and
you.
And let's just kick things off with a little game, a quick quiz. It's called The Down Low with Demi.
Oh, yeah, Demi, girl. Down Low.
All right,
I
Demi,
like that.
Tell me the three greatest things about you.
The three greatest things about me, there is just an infinite list.
So many.
but really, probably like the first thing I would say is that I am very relatable, even though I am like this very confident, boisterous person. If you get to know me on a personal level, I'm very relatable. I am very empathetic, even though you might not know that because a lot of it like wasn't shown. I am empathetic. And I think that empathy can save the world, honestly. Mm. And then third thing, I am a very, very loyal person. That's what it is.
I'm
very loyal.
Qualities. Yeah. Well, I have to say I've met a lot of girls from your season and they all speak so highly of you. Kaylin said you don't have a mean bone in your body. So I think that goes with empathetic and loyal. And I know Hannah G loves you too.
Oh my gosh, my girl Hannah.
Yeah, and I know you guys had a crew during The Bachelor, right?
The Triple HD.
The Triple HD, including Hannah Brown, Bachelorette. We will be talking about her in a little bit. Next question is, what is your spirit animal? Demi.
An orca.
And
I love
you
orcas.
You said that right away. You knew why.
Because orcas are, well, I mean, not to call myself intelligent, but orcas are like the most intelligent animal. And they, like, if you do some research about them, they are actually super fascinating. Mm-hmm. And I just feel like they're so loyal to their clan. Like, I think they call it a clan whenever they're in the ocean and stuff. Not in captivity, which is terrible. But whenever they're in the ocean, they have a clan and they're very loyal to it and they stick together. And yeah, I think orcas are just beautiful.
Well, you're beautiful. And you are very intelligent and very well spoken.
Thank you.
Your vocabulary is very impressive, Demi.
Oh, thank you.
So if Hannah B is Hannah Beast, what does that make you?
Queen Demi.
Queen Demi. I also thought of, have you seen Stranger Things?
Yes, of course.
You're the Demigorgon.
The Demigorgon.
Right?
Oh, that's a good
Hannah
one.
Hannah Beast and the Demigorgon.
Oh my gosh, I love that.
Dream duo, right?
No,
like, dynamic
seriously.
Duo.
Seriously.
Okay, finally, Demi, if you could be friends with any celebrity, who would you choose?
Brie Larson.
Ooh.
I love her so much. She's not only like an amazing actress. I remember I fell in love with her whenever she did a speech, like for, I think she won an Oscar or something.
Yeah.
And she did a speech, and she did a speech over it. And everything that she said, like, I was just so fascinated by her. And like, she is a phenomenal woman. And I look up to her.
Captain Marvel too, right? She's like a superhero.
That is the coolest thing that's ever happened in this decade. No, what is it? Century.
Century, decade, all of it. Okay, well, last week was the finale of The Bachelor, and Colton gave his final rose to Cassie. So how do you feel about how everything ended up?
You know, it was crazy. I felt really bad for Hannah G and everything that happened with her. But I will say that I am so happy for Cassie and Colton. I've talked to them like since.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we chit chat all the time and I'm obsessed with them. We're all homies and they seem like they're really, really happy together. Mm. So I'm happy that they both, you know, they found love with each other. Yeah. I mean, that's what we were there for essentially.
It seemed like you had like a special friendship with your boy Coco.
Oh, Coco. I love Coco. He is a hoot.
Is he? Okay, so There was some drama on The Bachelor this season, right? And there was a little tension with you and Tracy, but Tracy was here last week and she said that things are totally cool with you guys now.
Oh yeah, no, me and Tracy are so good. Me and Tracy's beef pretty much ended in Singapore and then it kind of like switched from Tracy to me and Courtney. Yeah. But Tracy and I, like, we just had a little bit of like a misstep in the beginning of the season, the age thing, you know, we kind of just were like feeding off of each other, like dogging each other for our age and stuff. But now, no. I mean, I just saw her like last weekend.
I know. I saw that. Elise actually admitted that she was the first one to make a cougar comment.
She was. She was. And so I just thought it was funny.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes I can think things are funny and take it a little too far. But no, I adore Elise too. I adore Tracy. I have nothing against cougars. I love cougars.
Yeah, cougars are great.
Cougars are great.
There was also, as you mentioned, drama with Courtney. Mm-hmm. So what was going through your mind when she put a pacifier in your mouth at the Women Tell All?
Fury. It was just pure fury. I felt unsafe in the moment, yeah. Just because I mean, it was crazy. I never thought that I would be like physically assaulted. But yeah, I've talked to her and she regrets what she did. And I told her, like, you know, I probably am insensitive to your feelings and like during all of that, you know, yeah. And I was just like saying stuff that I thought was funny and I wasn't considering how she might feel. So I was in the wrong to an extent and she was definitely in the wrong.
Absolutely. I mean, that was aggressive and that was uncalled for.
Yeah, it was definitely uncalled for. And it was, I think that, you know, if we don't need to act that way. This, like, you know, we're on ABC. This is supposed to be like a little bit classy. I know I'm not the classiest gal in the bunch, but I just thought that she could have handled it differently. I wouldn't have even been mad if she would have like thrown it at me or handed it to me, but to like shove it in my face, it was too much.
Well, where do you guys stand now?
We've talked and we're cool, and I said it's behind us. We're not gonna be friends. Like, yeah. That's just not gonna happen. It's okay to not be friends with somebody. Yeah. There's millions of people in the world. You're not gonna get along with all of them.
No.
So we're good. It's behind us and we will act civilized from now on.
Good. Well, do you think that there was a villain this season on The Bachelor?
No, I really don't think there was a villain. I think that, you know, a lot of people would say that I was like the closest thing to the villain, but that was more in the beginning. And once, like, you know, people got to know me more and see more of me, I think that they aren't feeling that way anymore.
Also, I've just developed this theory over the years watching The Bachelor. I feel like the villain sometimes is actually just someone who's super funny, super smart, and makes these comments that are facetious. Like, you're not taking them seriously, but they might, out of context, seem mean-hearted, but I don't think that they were coming
from you.
Absolutely,
and I think that, too, whenever you're in that environment, like, all the girls, everybody's pretty focused on how they're going to look on TV and their image, and so whenever you have someone who is doing the opposite of that, and you're outspoken, and you're being real,
yeah.
And most of the girls would probably say that if there wasn't, like, a camera in front of them, you know, they would, like, act more like how I did,
yeah.
But that camera will scare you, and you want to act right, and you don't want to, like, embarrass your friends and your family and stuff, so you kind of hinder a lot of your personality, but I was like, oh, no. I'm about to shine.
Yeah, and you did shine. So speaking of being real, your girl, Hannah Brown,
is the new Bachelorette. Yay!
How did you react when you found out?
I cried. I was like tears of joy. I was so happy for her. You know, I think I could say this because, like, Robert Mills has done, like, a lot of interviews about it, and he said, like, it came down to me and her.
Oh, Demi, I didn't know that.
Yeah, I didn't think that would ever happen. I was like, there's no way I would ever be considered, but I was. And so I thought it was great. I even in my interviews with him, I said, I either want it to be me or Hannah Brown. Like, my girl Hannah Brown deserves this. She talks about marriage all the time. She's ready to be married, and I think she honestly will do a better job than I would have done.
Oh, you would have been great and super entertaining. But why do you think Hannah's going to be a great bachelorette?
Because Hannah's real. Hannah's raw. She, you know, a lot of people, like, comment about how awkward she can be and stuff like that, but I think that's very relatable.
Yes.
I think that Hannah Brown is so relatable. I think that she has such a kind, true heart, and she really is ready to get engaged, and I know that she's gonna find love out of this. I just know it.
So we saw on your Instagram that you were with Hannah, helping her get ready for her big day. So what can you tell us about that?
You know, I can't say much about it, but you never know what's gonna happen. You know, who knows how her season's gonna go, if there will be a Demi appearance or not, we'll see.
Oh, please, we need a Demi cameo. So does it seem like she's having fun?
Yeah, no, yeah. She was so excited whenever I saw her. I think she is going to kill it. Like, I think this is going to be one of the best Bachelorette seasons that we have ever seen.
I think so, too. I'm really excited for her. And as you said, she's so relatable. I actually think it's refreshing that she's just so herself. She's not trying to be this, like, poised, perfect.
No, and it's surprising because, you know, she was a pageant girl. And I'm like, The Bachelor, whenever she was on there, she broke out of that pageant world and she became the beast. And we need the beast.
Release the beast. I think that should be her tagline.
Seriously.
Release the beast.
Release the beast.
Okay, so ABC, you know, just an idea. But any thoughts on her group of guys? Because the list has been revealed. We've seen the guys. Do you think any standouts are there?
I mean, I think that there were some really bad photos, but aside from that,
kind of agree,
I definitely see some guys that I'm like, oh, that's her type. That's her type. I think she's going to really have some standouts. And I think it's going to, the cool thing about Hannah, she's so real that she's not going to keep around anyone who she doesn't feel it with. Like, I just feel like she's going to be eliminating them left and right.
Really?
Yeah.
So what is her type, if you had to say?
Coco.
Like physically?
Yeah, like she likes her like a strong, big man. Oh, religion is really big to her, so I know that someone has to be religious for her. I think that it's just, I don't know, like, if you would know if, like, you know, whenever we see them interact, I feel like we'll all be able to tell from the beginning, like, oh, she's getting along with this guy. Yeah. This guy is going to give her what she needs. Mm-hmm. She's, like, one of the most amazing women that I've ever met. And so she deserves one of the most amazing men that we will ever meet. Yeah.
Do you think she needs a guy that can keep her on her toes and is, like, fun and goofy? Or almost someone that can kind of ground her more?
No, I think that she wouldn't put up with somebody trying to ground her more. Ooh. I think she needs somebody who's going to be right by her side egging her on. I mean, like, look at mine and her friendship. Like, we got along so well because we just fed into each other.
Yeah, and she gave the rose to Cam, who, like, did that crazy rap.
Yeah. So funny. It was so funny. I was like, okay.
I was like, good for you, Cam.
Like, I was like, he's got the beats, okay?
And, like, also a lot of pressure, like a full audience.
Yeah,
right?
I loved that. That
I
was
loved
so fun.
It, too. Okay, so everyone wants to know Demi. Are you going to be on Bachelor in Paradise?
I don't know. We'll see. I mean, I can't leave Chris Harrison out there by himself.
No.
I gotta go hang out with my spirit animal.
Is he your spirit animal?
Yes, and he said that I was his, and I'm like, we have so much fun together. I love him.
Okay, so if you were to go to Paradise, who would you like to see there from Bachelor Nation?
There's really not anybody from, like, past seasons that I would be interested in seeing there, but I'm not closed-minded to that. Okay. I just, like, there's nobody, I mean, I've seen enough of all of them.
And we haven't met Hannah's guys yet.
Exactly. So. I've seen some photos. Got my eye on, like, one of them from her photos. But
can
I got to
tell us who?
No. Oh. I'm going to let her. Because what if she ends up with him? And then I'm like, uh-oh.
That's a good point. It's like, I was just kidding.
Yeah, I didn't mean that. Y'all are so cute together.
Uh-oh. Okay, so we'll have to wait and see. But I'm already, like, wondering what your intro moment is going to be. Have you thought about that?
Oh my gosh, I have not thought about that. I'm sure it'll be like, if I had to choose, it would probably be me like pouring a bottle of champagne on myself.
Yes. Like maybe in a robe with a bikini underneath.
Yes, and right? I need to get a cuter robe. Note. I look so ridiculous in that robe.
Maybe like a silk robe?
Yeah, like something actually cute, not floral. One that I like got as a free gift at Ulta.
Did you really?
Yes. I just wore that robe around the house all the time, so that's why whenever everyone was shocked about it, I was like, girls, I'm in this every day.
I love that you brought a robe on the Bachelor.
It's my cozy robe. It was so cold around there. I was so happy whenever I got to put it on because I was so cold.
I love robe life. That's amazing.
Robe life is life.
It is life. No, Demi, you really own who you are, like all of who you are, including being promiscuous, as you put it. How have people reacted to that?
Positively.
I just think it's also empowering how you kind of embraced your sexual identity and like,
yeah,
as you said, it's like 2019.
This is the time for it and there's nothing wrong with it. So.
Oh, absolutely nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, I love it.
Yes. Okay, so you also opened up about your mom who was in prison. Mm-hmm. So how is she doing now?
She's doing better than I have seen her in years. Oh. She is so happy. I mean, I absolutely hate that she had to go to prison, and it was really hard for her, and it was hard on all of us in the family, but I think that she had a lot of time, like, to reflect and just decide that she wants to move her life in a different direction, mm-hmm. and she's doing so good now, aww. And she was actually, I haven't got to see her yet, because she lives far away from me, and I've been so busy since the show ended. Or started, and then, but last weekend she was with my brother, and my brother called me, and he was like, Demi, I'm nervous. He was like, I don't know how this is gonna be, and then they FaceTimed me whenever they were together, and it was like, my old mommy was back. It was really sweet.
That's so sweet. I'm sure your story has inspired a lot of people as well.
Yeah, there are a lot of people who have reached out to me and, like, thanked me for telling my story because they can relate, and it's a topic that nobody really wants to talk about because it's really intense and it can be embarrassing and you can feel like ashamed, but I think that that's the problem that we're having in this world right now. Like, we need to talk more about things that make us uncomfortable. And yeah, I mean, I hope that I've helped some people with, you know, if they have similar stories, but yeah, I'm grateful that I could do that for people and that I could speak about something that most people like can't speak about.
Yeah, well, I think that that's actually the similarity between you and Hannah Brown is that you are so vulnerable and so open. You're not just only trying to show like the picture perfect sides of your life, mm-hmm. and that's I think why people relate to you.
Yeah, definitely. I I'm not picture perfect and I'm a mess. And yeah, that's why me and Hannah, I remember specifically in the mansion whenever we became friends, she had gone on her one-on-one date and like she came back. And before her one-on-one date, she was doing her like, you know, her inability to like speak publicly kind of thing, you know, like being awkward and cute. I mean, I always adored her. I thought she was so cute. But we kind of just started talking and she saw like how real I was being. And she was like, I like you, Demi. She was like, I really like you. And so after that, we just started like feeding into each other and fueling each other's fire, and we became a dynamic duo, and she became the best Hannah she could ever be.
Oh my gosh, you are so supportive. It's like really wonderful
I'm
to see that.
I'm obsessed with her. I love her so much.
Too bad that she won't be in paradise.
I know. That was the thing. I was like, hey, at least if neither one of us get the Bachelorette, we'll get to burn that beach to the ground, sis.
I really hope we'll see you there, Demi. It's going to be, if so, a really entertaining season.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Always keeping it entertaining.
Now, you've watched The Bachelor for years, right? Mm-hmm. So who have you fangirled the most over?
Like
someone that you've met who's been on the show. Like, from past seasons?
Like a Bachelorette or a Bachelor?
Yeah, anyone, really. Like, I know you met Nick Viall.
Oh, my gosh. I was, like, obsessed with him. And then, we're really good friends now, and it's so weird. It's kind of like I haven't got to meet a lot of them. Oh, Ashley,
she's love great
her. Too. Oh my gosh, we had dinner. Like, we're so
look
cool.
Look at you, girl.
I know. I'm like, what is my life? Meeting all these legends, these icons.
And when I saw you like on the stairs with Crystal and Ben Higgins.
Oh yeah, no,
right?
They were all so great. Like, I remember I gave Ben a hard time because I was like, I heard you called me a pest on your podcast, and he like sat there and he was like holding my hands. He's like, Demi, I do not think you're a pest. Like. So sweet. We had so much fun together, me and all that group. Crystal is a doll. I love her too. She's so cute.
She's really cute. She and Chris together.
Oh my gosh, Chris the goose.
Yeah.
He is a gem. Seriously.
He is a gem.
And he's like grown up so much. I mean, I didn't know him before, but like from the show whenever he was on Becca's season, he is so mature. And I thought it was cool how on our panel, like, you know, during the finale, like we were all making like sexual jokes and stuff, and he was over there being like super serious and real. I was like, okay, goose, I see you.
Yeah, right? Crystal has like brought this out of him, I think.
Yes, yeah. They are so cute together. They're like, so I'm obsessed. Cute.
And then finally, is there anyone that you're still dying to meet from the Bachelor world?
I want to meet Rachel Lindsay. Rachel, if you're listening, I want to meet you.
Wait, you're from Dallas. She lives in Dallas.
I know. Why? I think she's moving.
Is she moving?
She's moving to Miami, I think.
Okay, but before she does, you need to meet her.
I know.
You're in the same city.
If I only was there, I'm always here now. Yeah.
Are you thinking about moving to LA?
I don't know. I mean, I'm thinking about it just so I can, like, I don't have to travel 3 hours on a plane every other week. But, seriously. But no, I want to meet her. I think that she was, like, well, and Caitlin Bristow. I've kind of talked with Caitlin Bristow a bit, but they were my two favorite Bachelorettes ever. Mm. They're real, they're funny, and I am inspired by them, and I admire them, so I would love to meet them.
Well, let's just end with, do you have a story or anything that didn't make it to air that, like, you wish people had seen, like, maybe a funny memory with Hannah B.?
Okay, so this is like one of my favorite moments. It wasn't actually funny, but it was like just really special with me and her. We were walking back in Thailand from the group date, cocktail party. And all the girls are like walking in this big crowd going back to the room, and me and Hannah were just frolicking along like the waterline, like the shoreline. Me and her were like spinning and dancing, and like we had this really special moment that me and her to this day, we both agree, one of the best moments ever. Oh my gosh, and I have one more.
Oh my, please, tell us everything.
Nobody knows this, not even the producers. One night, me, Hannah B, and Heather snuck out and went skinny dipping in the ocean.
No, you didn't.
Yes, we did. This is first time coming out.
You heard it here first.
We did.
Oh my gosh.
It was so fun.
They never found out?
No, and I didn't think that they would care, probably. Like, we were just out there having a good time.
It was so
fun, and it was something that like we'll be able to remember forever.
Granted,
Katie and Hannah G were in the other room or in our room too, and we were like, "Hey, we're going skinny dipping. Y'all want to come?" And they're like dead asleep. They're like, "No."
Wait, you kind of need to recreate that in paradise.
Oh my gosh!
Right?
I do. Write that down.
Write that down.
Noted.
Noted. Yes. Thank you for sharing that. That's
such
a fun story, and I think it also like just shows your personalities. You guys are just ready for anything. For
adventure. A little never been kissed Heather going skinny dipping in Thailand. Sorry, Heather.
Thank you for being here, Demi. You're such a sweetheart. I'm glad we all got to know you better. Woo. And thanks for watching, you guys. Hopefully we'll see this girl in paradise, and we will see you guys next time.
Thanks.
Bye.
Woo. One more extra, hit the subscribe button and the bell. Never miss a video.